just throughout my life. I did it for 5 years in high school. I help out with it now that I'm in college, and Jared and I are coaches now that we're in college at our local debate club. And it's been really, had a tremendous impact on my life and who I am today. I think we're both helping out at these camps because we have that confidence that years of debate has sort of inspired in us. And I had a little bit of an opportunity this week to hopefully channel some of that into my students, all of which were great. I want to thank start off by thanking Tori, who stood up this week and was my helper and couldn't have done it without her. In the meantime, well, some of my students wanted to explain some of the things that we talked to you guys about this week, starting off with Noah and Brooks.
Okay, so he's going to draw the way that a round is conducted, which is essentially a debate, and it's cut up into 8 segments. Yeah, and so the first 4 are constructive debates, and then the last 4 are rebuttals. And there's the negative team, and then there's the affirmative team. And the affirmative team affirms the resolution, and the negative team denies the resolution. And they have a debate over a resolution that can be really complicated or really simple, like cats versus dogs. So now I can actually see what we're doing. So the top half of these 4 are constructive arguments, debates, constructive arguments. Sorry, and then which is by one of the teams. So this is the first constructive affirmative argument, and that's the first constructive negative argument. And then down at the bottom, they have cross-examination questions. And these 4 are all 8 minutes long, and then these are all 3 minutes long. And prep time, thank you. Prep time, you get 3 minutes of prep time during the whole entire round, which is like 38 minutes, right? I think. Non-traditionally, it is 38 minutes, and I'm really out. I probably don't even need this. Anyway. So the rebuttals are, these are where you build up your case, and these are where you tear down your opponent's case, pretty much. And so prep time, you get prep time, is where you spend, you get 3 minutes altogether, and you can divide it up however you want to, and you kind of work with your colleague and build your argument and just, you know, talk through it and stuff. So I think that's about it.
In debate camp, we also learned about 4 stock issues. The 4 stock issues are topicality, which is the question, is it on topic? And inherency, is there a problem? Significance, is it important? And solvency, will it work?
I'm Sarah Schumper, and another thing that we learned in debate are the 2 types of evidence. There are 2 types of evidence: traditional evidence, which is like books, online sources, media, and logical evidence, which is the art and science of reasoning well.
We learned about argumentation and warrants and stuff. And argumentation is about claims and warrants. For warrants are your reasoning of evidence for your claim. Debating is undermining your opponent's claims by interpreting, explaining, or refuting your opponent's warrants.
Hello, my name is Joseph, and we learned in debate that you can use, there are methods of debating you can use without sacrificing or jeopardizing your beliefs and your concerns.
Hi, my name is William, and in debate camp, we also learned that in debate, when writing an affirmative or negative strategy, it is important to write or argue about something you care about. If you don't care about your argument, neither will your opponent.
Hello, my name is Cornelius Plummer, and the purpose of debating is so you can not press but persuade your opponent to your belief. spiritually, politically, and other ways, etc.
Hey y'all, I'm Annalisa Blevins, and our first debate that we had in class was cats versus dogs, and we debated this subject on many levels, such as the compatibility of the pet with the owner, the health risks posed by each animal, also the affordability of each animal, and we had a lot of fun with that too.
Hi, my name is Josiah Lewis, and we also debated about banning the infamous fidget spinner from classrooms at different levels, the utility of a ban, and the consequences of giving a limited ban for students that have special needs. So like putting a visible label on them so the teacher will know, hey, you can have a fidget spinner in class.
So we had two debates yesterday. We had the debate this morning on whether home economics should be required in college. We had a lot of fun discovering that a third of college students don't know how to boil an egg. Additionally, this evening we'll have another debate on whether the driving age should be lowered to 14, which I'm really looking forward to. But as you can see, we have